Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Prayoga Wiradi from Universitas 11 Maret. We'll present to you about my research about nonlinear assessment of cold water pipe, or CWP, on the ocean thermal energy conversion, or OTEC, insulation under bending load. In this presentation, I will explain the introduction why of this research need to be done, the previous study of relative to buckling, the finite element setting used in this research, the result and discussion of this research, and the conclusion. Introduction. The Ocean Thermal Energy Convention, or OTEC, is a floating platform that functions to convert energy, seawater heat energy, into electricity. Cold water is taken from the sea with depth of 800 to 1000 meter through cold water pipe, or CWP. This long CWP size causes unavoidable bending load due to seawater flow. The extreme diameter per thickness ratio of the CW pipe makes this pipe susceptible to buckling. In this research, numerical validation and mass conversion study was carried out for CWP OTEC research under the next bending load. Objective and scope the work. This research was conducted to validate the numerical analysis and find the mass convergence. A cylindrical cell is used as a model in this study. The cylinder is given a moment on the one side and the other side is fixed end. The number of mass used in this is varied in order to obtain a convergent mass. Previous study about buckling. The following equation are some of a equation that have been made from previous study that has been carried out. The critical moment formula can be seen in equation 1. The moment in the plastic region can be seen in equation 2. And the relationship between moment and pipe curvature can be seen in equation 3. Finite element setting, geometry. For the current study, the model from Yadav and Geramisis was reproduced for future research. In the study, the radius per thickness ratio used was 60. Using the model shape imperfection, model with an imperfection magnitude W0 per T of 0.1, the diameter of the cylinder is 4000 mm and the length is 2000 mm. Finite element setting material properties. The material used in this model is steel. The steel has a yield strength of 355 MPa, Young's modulus of 210 GPa, and Poisson ratio of 0.3. In this model, Rambert-Osgood plasticity model is used. For Rambert-Osgood model equation for the steel can be seen in equation for boundary condition. In boundary condition, one side of the pipe is fixed. So U1 equal U2 equal U3 equal UR1 equal UR2 equal UR3 is equal to 0. And the other end of the pipe was applied moment. Result and discussion benchmarking. In this validation, the result of the present study will be compared to the result of Yadav and Geramisis in 2019. The result were obtained using static risk method in the Abacus software. The moment is normalized by T square times by T times by sigma y, and the curvature is normalized by T over T square. The similarity is seen in the elastic spark when the two curves coincide. In addition, the similarity can be seen in the post-buckling where two curves also coincide. However, the place where the critical moment occurs in the reference is earlier than the study conducted. This can be caused by different material input, especially during the transition between elastic and plastic deformation. In this figure, the stress control is when there is no load, so there is no stress occur. When the observation is continued to this figure, it can be seen that the structure has undergone plastic deformation. It can be seen in the maximum stress that has exceeded that given yield strength. However, it not yet past critical moment. In the next figure, it can be seen that the structure has passed critical moment so that at the time the structure has failed. When it continues, it can be seen in this figure, where the failure area will get bigger. In this case, the stress propagation only occurs on the one side and the one direction. This is because the component of this structure is just one component. Displacement control. For displacement control, it can be seen that the displacement occurs only half of the pipe. The higher the end of the pipe, the greater displacement that occurs. This can be caused by strain that occurs. From the strain control, it can show that the strain that occurs only in the middle of the pipe. Mass convergence study. In this study, a convergent mass study is carried out to determine the mass that can use for further research on the OTAC. In this study, a mass convergent study was carried using the step buckle in Abaco software. The model of this study is model used before. A straight line is drawn, which is used to observe where the convergence occurs. The trend line indicates that the starting mass size of 55 millimeter if the number of elements.
Rayoda, we have. Let's move to the conclusion because the time is almost finished.
Oh, yeah. The conclusion, the result of the numerical validation shown that the similarity of the study with reference is 50%. The similarity can be influenced by different material inputs. In displacement control, propagation only occurs on the one side. This is because the structure only consists of the one component, so the direction of the stress does not fluctuate. The results of the mass convergence study show that the mass size of 55 millimeter is suitable for a future research. This is because 55 millimeter mass size has result that are not much different from the smaller size, but it has much smaller number of element compared to the smaller size. That's all for me. Thank you for your attention.